Hello and welcome to Society Talk Show Games Edition. My name is George and today's talk show is being held because on Sunday here at Staffs Uni we have an esports taster day. This is an event being hosted at LRV 10 to 6:30 this Sunday. The event will be showcasing CSGO, Dragon Ball, League of Legends and Overwatch. Here's a clip showing you what's going on.
The event's been running for a couple of years, but really hit off last year. It was a collaboration between a group of students who thought esports is a growing market and there was a lot of attention at the university. And we thought that it would be a great idea to put on an event where everyone could come and see all these passionate people do what they do. My role now lecturing, I'm hoping to then pass this on to students to run for themselves and to get work, a really valuable work experience from. Where some people last year actually got jobs from doing this event. We had a lot of people from down south and up north come and visit as well. We had people from Plymouth to Edinburgh when we advertised it, and that was amazing. And the whole idea of it was just that it's a community that can come together who enjoy playing games. And for the local community, for Stoke, we're really going to put it out in the advertisement this year for Stoke, because we want people who may not be able to go to these events to be able to come and see A, what Staffs can do and how good we are, but also so they don't have to take their families and their children on that and spend all this money going to these far off like locations, like if they don't have the money to do that, or maybe it's just too inconvenient in the week. We'll supply a free day that they can come and enjoy themselves. Because of that and the hype that it's got and the fantastic amount of people that's come, we've had the BBC interested in watching this now. Last year we actually did some interviews and such ones. And Twitch has been quite interested, so much so on that, that we're talking to them about actually putting it on their front page, etc., which has been really good news. We've had great contact with external companies, or actually some of them who I can't name just yet, but it's going to be a surprise when you see them, are in contact with us about supplying free games. It's good to see that industry support that community all the time. I would say it's getting bigger and it's getting better. We have a larger variety of production available. We've got more events for people to do. We've got a better quality production as well, since last year we've acted on some feedback. But that's the idea for the students to see, that they will keep growing this and make it better, and eventually they'll reach the point where it's top-notch industry standard. Our last year actually got event of the year, and that was a great feeling, and that's the feeling I want to pass on to every single student that does this event every year. And I want them to aim to make sure that they could get event of the year every year, and I know they can do that. It's been fantastic to work with all these different societies. We couldn't do it without the help of our Stats TV, and this year we're excited because we've got OMG involved as well. So we're hitting both physical production, as in the TV, and we're doing the radio as well, so we're really excited. It's all about gaining experience from this event. So as an idea, we have kits supplied by Overclockers that you'll see, and they're a fantastic help towards everything we do. They supply all the computers, the mice, the keyboards. We have Stats TV who help us and they supply all the production behind the scenes stuff, such as the cameras, the mics, they do the vision mixing, the sound, etc. And they're all volunteers, and that's something I really want to stress, like that's how good our community is. That's kind of what really sums up Staffs as well. It's that whole feeling of we've got production, we've got passion, we've got experience. We're actually flying out alumni from different countries that are coming back just to help out in the production and to put on this event. That's how passionate it is when you join Staffs. That's why we say proud to be Staffs. So 21st of October, LRV. 10 a.m. till 6:30 p.m.
Now this all looks very exciting, but for those of you who are unsure what exactly esports is, I have here with me Marcus and Chris, who are representing the Esports Society today. Thanks for joining us. So what exactly is esports?
So esports are video games taken to a competitive level. They're broadcast online. Recently there have been tournaments that have been broadcast on American TV. It's all kind of blowing up recently, and we as a society are going to push esports at Staffs.
And what do you guys do in your society?
So at the society, we build teams for National University Esports League, which is a tournament run, as well as the National Students Esports, which is another tournament that runs with different games to the Newell. We want to build teams, put them into scrims, which is where they play against other university teams, so that they can build their teamwork, make sure that they're at the top level that they can be.
So now we know what your society does, I want to know, how did you guys come about? Did you start the society and why? And if not, why are you a part of it?
So this year we started the society because we wanted to create a niche area where everyone who's interested in competing can come together and make sure that they all get exactly what they want, as there are other societies revolving around video games, but they're more broader, and we want to kind of focus on that niche competing in esports section.
Okay, so just before you go, can you tell us where and when you meet and how often, and what's your membership? Is it for anyone who might be considered joining?
So most of our meetings are online, as it's easier to bring everyone together, and then we can run events easier. It's more efficient to do it that way. We meet about once a week, and we rotate between different games for Pugs, which are pickup games where we run random teams, they play together for a bit of fun, gets everyone to know each other, also emphasises the competitive spirit of the society, and our membership's £5 for anyone who's interested in joining.
Fantastic. Well, thank you guys for coming on to the show, and we look forward to seeing you at the weekend. It's not just esports who we're talking to today. We're also talking to some of the other game societies knocking around at the campus, starting with Jay from the Video Game Society. Thanks for coming along. So, who are you and what do you do?
Well, the Video Game Society is more for the casual and competitive side. So, if you've played like Sonic, Crash Bandicoot, any games like that that you've enjoyed or been infuriated with, we're probably the society for you. And it's also good to have other gamers come along and just try these games out. So that's what we offer.
That sounds like quite a bit of fun, actually. So we've got a clip showing what you do, so we can take a look at that if you're up for it.
Yeah.
Looking good there. Now, we've seen what you've done so far, so what do you guys have planned for the year? Any events planned?
I mean, next week in itself, on Monday, we've also got a gaming taster session in the LRV. Following that, we're working with the esports on the Sunday as well, and we also have our social meetups every Tuesday. We try to aim for the Collision Space in Mellor. We've had Switches set up there, the PS4s, Xboxes, and we've also had Jackbox for people to just try and have a laugh. So we try to reach out to everyone in those sort of areas.
And who organises all this? Are you part of the committee members?
Yeah,
did you found the society?
It is the committee that organises it as well as the head. The head is Andrew Sherborne. We're just the guys that help run it as well. So that'd be it.
So what's your role within the society?
Mine would be finance, to be fair. I am one of the head committee members.
Oh, okay.
But I also help run the social, the socials and so forth, mm-hmm. because I try to get as many things running there as I can.
Okay, so it's pitch time now. So why should people be joining your society?
Well, for the main reasons like I've said before. So it's like if you enjoy casual gaming and you just want other people to just have a laugh in a gaming night with, we're the society for you. Even if it's competitive as well, we do offer that to a certain extent. Not as extreme as esports does, but we are still on the table for that as well.
And finally, if anyone out there does want to join, when and where do you meet? How much is the membership and how can they get in touch?
So our membership cost is £3. You can join through the union website, you can join through Facebook and stuff like that, because we have all the links available where we can. We also have a Discord server that people can communicate on to just to meet other gamers. And we meet every Tuesday like I've said, in the Collision space from 5 p.m. onwards, and we host our events there.
Well, thank you very much for coming along.
Thank you very much.
Next up, we have a more specific club who, rather than being about video games in general, they focus on a certain type of gaming. Now, we're not supposed to talk about it, but we're breaking the first rule for this. So please welcome Jack and Alex from Fight Club. So how are you guys doing today?
Doing very well. How are you?
Yeah, I'm not too bad, actually. Yeah,
yeah, pretty good. Yeah.
So let's get to it. So what do you guys get up to?
So we do sessions on a Thursday where we basically get a load of fighting games like Tekken, Dragon Ball, Street Fighter, pretty much all of them, actually. And we get casuals and competitive players alike to just play fighting games for a few hours, pretty much as most of it, yeah. And then the occasional tournament.
Well, and let's take a clip at you guys. Take a look at a clip of you guys in action.
We're Fight Club. We just meet up and play fighting games every week. Just have a nice chill atmosphere. No matter the skill level of the players, it's just getting together and sharing a genre that we all love.
I have a big thing for tournaments, so I'm trying to make it at least every 2 months now. But basically we just rent out one of the venues, maybe Verve, LRV, which I prefer Verve because everyone could have a pint and play, which is kind of cool. So I just basically organize these events, and then we will normally do 3 games according to like what's relevant at the time.
I mean, our society's existed for a year. We're already at the point where we're repping a major uni event, which I can't say I expected to happen in the slightest, but I guess here we are.
It's pretty cool because before I came to this uni, I didn't think that fighting games were big in the UK at all. I just kind of gave up. Basically, I joined there and it was just a bunch of people in a room, exactly like me, who just loved fighting games. And now that it's like, oh, we're going to have tournaments against other unis, it's awesome.
So why do you guys do what you do? Did you start the society or did you just join as members and climb your way up?
So I joined in my first year, seeing it as a society fair, and I seen the setup was just Tekken and Skullgirls, and you know, the rest is history. Became the community manager this year. I work alongside Connor and Alex here to bring the service of fighting games to the people of the uni.
Yeah. And I joined in the end of my first year in uni because I saw an advert for a tournament and just went. Just thought, why not? And everybody was really friendly. So I just kind of went every now and then, and I grew to like the society more and more, and now I'm the tournament organizer for the community. Yeah.
So you'd recommend the society then?
Oh, yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Well, here's your chance. For anyone that wants to join, where do you meet, when do you meet, and how much is membership?
So it's Beacon Building, room T105, first floor, and it's a Thursday at 5 p.m, and the membership is completely free.
And if you want to reach us on Facebook, just type in Staff's Fight Club and ask to become a member, and me and Jack will pretty much let you through instantly. And that's where we post all of our events, tournaments, everything to get you up to speed.
We have a Discord as well, and that's mainly just communication, tech talk, and games on nights.
Oh, fantastic. Well, thank you very much for coming along, guys.
No worries. Cheers for having us.
Up next, we have another specialist gaming club. This one is based around a popular Nintendo game. Please welcome Oliver and Alex from Staff Smash. Thank you guys for coming. So what is Staff Smash all about?
So Staff Smash is about community,
integrity,
and heart. And we play Super Smash Brothers.
Well, let's take a look at what you guys look like when you're in action.
Oh,
Well, so that's what you guys do at the moment then. So are you guys the founders, and why did you join the society if you didn't start it?
So I started the society. It was me and my roommate Ed in first year, and I've been away from the uni for a year, so Alex and various other members have looked after the society for me in the meantime. And this is the president over here.
Well, do you guys have any plans for the future?
Yeah, so the Super Smash Brothers community is large and all over the UK, so we're trying to expand out of Staffordshire itself, and we're thinking of heading to different tournaments all over the place. There's lots of different tournaments.
There's like South London, Four Quarters.
Four Quarters. And we're trying to run our own, but we also run casuals as well.
Sounds great. Well, guys, it's time to promote your society. Why should people join, and what info do they need to know? Like times, places, cost of a membership?
Top of Mellow.
Top of Mellow.
Fifth floor.
Room S500 on a Wednesday from 1 to 5. Come along if you just want to play some Smash and meet some pretty cool people.
We also have a Facebook group. You can find us at Facebook, Staff Smash.
Well, thank you very much, guys.
No problem.
Thank you.
Our final society is Overwatch. Now, sadly, they couldn't be here today, but Overwatch Society is an appreciation society for people to talk, play, or just do anything Overwatch related. They have a Discord and a Facebook where you can socialize with other members and talk about the latest Overwatch news. They meet up weekly in the Mellor building, S500, on Fridays from 5 till 9, where they play Overwatch and socialize with each other. They're also planning a charity live stream and a competition on Halloween. To get in touch, you can contact them on their Facebook page, Staff's Overwatch Society. Finally, before we go, I've walked back eSports to tell us some final details about the event on Sunday.
Well, the event is this Sunday. It is being hosted in the LRV from 10 till 6:30. We'll be showing CSGO, Dragon Ball, League of Legends, and Overwatch.
Yes, so we're going to have Myth, we're going to have VGS, we're going to have Fight Club, Smash, all around, so that everyone can get involved with the games. People can just rock up, just play on the computers, play on the Wii U's, that kind of stuff, just to get everyone involved so the family members know what their children want to do and why they want to do it.
Well, a big thank you to you guys, and a big thank you to everyone who has come down today. If you want to watch the event, tune in at 10 on Sunday to watch the games, commentary, interviews, and more. Keep an eye on Staff's TV, Twitter, and Facebook pages for updates on how and where you can watch. Thank you, and good night.